MOSAG is an empowerment for change organization operating the northern part of Ghana with limited national level engagement. The organization started in 2002, and as we develop and grow, we got to a point and asked ourselves how we're going to sustain ourselves. We discussed this, examined this particular issue among ourselves, and came up with a number of things, including getting ourselves a permanent office, and also introducing some models that will generate income for us. That is some years back. So fortunately, 2015, we managed to get our own office and move in. And so issues of sustainability when it comes to accommodation, when it comes to office premises, got resolved. Then this issue came up as civil society, funding dwindling, and then a limited opportunity for a civil society organization. We asked ourselves what we could do to insulate ourselves against any funding challenges. So we came up with a number of options. Fortunately for us, we got a project with ActionAid and were to mobilize 1,000 young women from 9 communities. We give some of them skill training in a number of areas, including beads making, soap making, fashion design, smoke weaving, local cloth weaving, so many other things. Same time, we're providing skills to young people on bicycle, motorbike mechanic, mobile phone repairs, and all that. So at the point, we saw that to be a potential that we could also get something back from graduates of the various skills program that we had initiated. So what we did was to get some of the people we graduated and to see how best we could support them to expand their business and also give something back to the organization. We found it to be one of the ways to generate money eternally. Well, this was after we had reflected and felt like, look, how can we be sustainable and make sure that we generate the needed income internally? Then the issue of social enterprise came up. When some of us came up with that issue, there was resistance. I presented it to my board. I told them that there was a need for us to do things differently, and that we had worked for more than 10 years just doing direct service delivery, advocacy, but we're not sure how we will exist when donors are no more, when donors are not giving us money. So I presented a proposal to the board to discuss our social enterprise concept. Unfortunately, the board, they felt like we're going to change focus, and they rejected that. So I left the issue several, I think a year or two, we got back to the board, tried to talk to some of them, explain why we felt like there was a need for us to diversify and begin to generate income internally. I remember that meeting, there was a split. Some board members said, okay, well, let's now look at the social enterprise aspect. So finally, there was that willingness to approve. But we got approval anyway, that we could become social enterprise. So we tried to, we accepted it and said we're going to register. And then the question was, what should happen? Or what will happen to our organization? Are we now moving and becoming a hybrid organization, or it's not just becoming hybrid, but just changing for good? So we tried to test the law. So we went to Register General to register this. The intention was to be hybrid organization, that we are able to do profit work and also have component of also focus on our non-profit mission. It was difficult to register that. We either register as local organization, non-for-profit, or we register as organization either for profit or organization that we should register based on shares, so that we have shareholders. So the only option we could do was to register the enterprise again. So to register a subsidiary organization, we call it NIV, Nosan Industrial Village. So that becomes our social enterprise agency. And then Nosan will continue its primary work of providing direct social services. So we had to do this because of the legal environment that we have. So we accepted it and we went that way. Now, I'm happy to say that we have made significant progress in our plans and plans to generate income internally. We started with what we call revolving fund. The revolving fund, I can tell you about 10,000 Ghana Cedi that we started with. Within a short period, as I speak now, we have about 89,000 Ghana Cedi. So you can imagine, no donor has contributed money except the 10,000 Ghana Empower gave us a seed capital. We have grown that amount of money and so many women groups are benefiting from it. The revolving fund is quite different from microcredit, VSLE and all that. It's unique and we are currently happy with the way we are piloting it in the district. What we are currently also doing is to establish what we call youth model market. We are trying to have all the graduates of our skill training program to get jobs at the center, at a place where you can perform some kind of double role, serve as a tourist site and also market for the young people. So we're going to have that. And currently we are in discussion with Sanargo Municipal Assembly and they have been very supportive. They are open to this and we are certain that the market will be established before the year end. But even before we established, we supported some of them to market their produce and all that. And just like we're going to do, once the market is established, we rent the place to our young people. Then they pay us the rent. And that is how we will generate income. We'll continue to look at other models. For example, we are taking a washing bay, car rental. These are not to just shift us from our core mandate, but to look at areas that are connected to the work that we want to do as an organization and make sure that we rake in the needed capital. I always say that it's better to spend time planning. And once you are convinced that this is workable, you are capable of doing this, go out there and test it. The fear will always be there. But if we allow the fear to limit our ways of thinking and our action, then we will never make progress. So any organization or individual who wants to venture into this, either transition their organization from just direct service or social provision organization to some kind of social enterprise, you just need to do self-retrospection, do that kind of analysis, and once you are convinced that you have your strategies right, please go out there, test your model, prepare your mind for challenges, and also prepare your mind to overcome those challenges when they emerge.